Hello, good morning. I'm Dr. M. Sandil Kumar. In this video, we'll see about how we made the electric scooter, converting an existing IC engine based scooter into electric vehicle. Actually, in past 3 months' time, we developed 5 different electric vehicles, including this electric scooter, for carrying 2 persons actually. So let us see the need for the electric vehicle. We all know that the crude oil is depleting. The fossil fuel is depleting now. Adding to that, in India, the petrol price crossed 100 plus across all the cities of India. The third one is because of the COVID, the wages and salaries of all private employees and workers have gone down. So all these three put together made us one thing, that the spending power has come down. But at the same time, we need a vehicle for transportation. So a cheaper sources of transportation has to be thought of and it has to be ventured. So that is the reason for me to go for the electric vehicle, making of electric vehicle. My prediction, the automobile will definitely exist because as I said earlier, without automobile, we cannot move from one place to the other place. So automobile must be there definitely, two-wheeler, three-wheeler or four-wheeler. The IC engine, petrol and diesel engine-based vehicles will diminish. The electric vehicles will play a major role predominantly in a matter of 3-4 years time. So the immediate alternative now is the electric vehicle. You all know that in the prevailing rate of petrol, diesel and electricity charge, if you use an electric vehicle, you can just spend 1/10 of the cost that you are spent for petrol and diesel. So you see the savings, the recurring savings. So why waiting? Jump into EV. The market potential of EV. The CEO of Tesla, Elon Musk, has become world's richest person just because of his Tesla electric car. So from this, you can understand the potential of the electric vehicle segment, the market. In India, all two-wheeler and car manufacturers started making electric vehicles. The projected Indian market potential on EV will be around 2 lakh crores. So, why don't you take up this as your business or a career? The business potential. This EV has a huge business potential, like cell level assembly, battery pack selling, making, conversion of IC engine based vehicles into electric vehicle, services on electric motors and controller, establishing and maintaining charging stations, battery swapping services, training services on electric vehicle, EV sales and service by opening a showroom. So you can choose any one, you can take up that as your business or a career. If you want to make an electric vehicle, these three are very important, that is battery, motor, controller. When it comes to battery, there are different types of batteries. Basically there are two different types of in a major way. They are lithium ion and lithium ferrophosphate, or simply abbreviated as LFP. So most of the electric vehicles, they use lithium ion, but we chose not lithium ion but the LFP, lithium ferrophosphate, because from this safety aspects, the lithium ferrophosphate battery will not explode or will not catch fire. So that is the reason for us to choose the LFP instead of lithium ion. The hub mode, the motor type, two different types. One is hub, other one is drive. In this case, the electric scooter, we use hub motor. Okay, we procured 1000 watts hub motor and we used it. For our electric car, we used drive motor, of course. The controller, single phase and three phase controllers are available in the market. This e-scooter hub is coming under this category, the three phase. Okay, now here in this project, we converted the existing petrol scooter into electric vehicle. We purchased a Mahindra Duro scooter. We removed the engine and the rear wheel, and we fitted the hub motor at the rear. Or you can create a new model also. Say the previous video, I think you saw about a skateboard model. For that skateboard model, it's a newly created one. We didn't do any conversion of any existing vehicle into skateboard. It's altogether, it's a new model. So there are, I said already about why we chose LFP, lithium ferrous phosphate, or lithium iron phosphate. This is the chemical symbol, chemical name. So there are two different configurations. They are cylindrical and prismatic. We use the cylindrical type. You can use the prismatic also. The single cell, cylindrical cell, is having a capacity of 3.2 volt, 6 amperes. So total power you can get from one single cell is 19.2 watts. So this is a single cell, cylindrical cell. We purchase many cells, hundreds of cells, to make battery packs for those five different vehicles. In this particular case, the e-scooter, we use this cell. I think this required nearly 90 phase cells actually. I'll explain when I show those slides. Okay. Now we have expertise in making the battery pack for EV from the cell level, with a capacity ranging from even just 100 watts to 100 kilowatts. So let's see about how we made this battery pack for this e-scooter. The hub motor is 1000 watts 60 volt type. So since the hub motor is 1000 watts and 60 volt type, we need to develop a battery pack of 60 volt, 1.8 kilowatt. The motor wattage is 1000. We added a factor of safety of 1.8, and we tried to make the battery pack of capacity 1800 watts or 1.8 kilowatts. So see the various stages of making. So actually this battery pack is comprising of four stages. This is the rack number one. Maybe in one rack, in the rack one, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 connected parallelly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 connected in series. So 5 in parallel and 5 in series this way. Then there are 4 racks, you know. So 4 racks are stacked one above the other. Of course, the 4th rack, so one, this first rack is having 5 into 5, 25 cells, you know. The 4th rack will not have 25 cells, rather it will have only 20. Okay, I'll tell you later why the 4th rack has only 20 instead of 25. So 25 plus 25 50 plus 25 75 plus 20 95. So to make a battery pack of 60 volt type 1.8 kilowatt, we required 95 cells. Used in this 95 cells, from this you can see, in this 95 cells we have done this part welding with 19 cells in series. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in one rack. Second rack 5, third rack 5, fourth rack only 4. So 5, 10, 15 and 19, not 20. So 19 cells are connected in series. So 19 into 3.2, one cell voltage is 3.2. So 19 into 3.2, it is approximately equal to 60 volt. So this is in series connection. Parallel, in the parallel connection board, we connected 5 cells in parallel. So then 5 into this 19, so 95 total. So that is the calculation. So 95 cells are required for making the 60 volt 30 ampere hour 1.8 kilowatt LFP battery pack for this e-scooter. Of course, all the battery packs must require a BMS, battery management system, because it will protect the battery from overcharging, over-discharging, undercharge, overcharge, high temperature, or heavy current, if at all, if it draws, it will cut off. So, say for example, suppose if it tries to draw the current abnormally, the BMS will disconnect the connection. So then the battery is protected. Same way, suppose if the temperature of the whole battery pack goes beyond certain level, maybe 65 degree centigrade or 70 degree centigrade, the BMS will disconnect the power from the battery to the motor. So that way, the BMS is it acts as a protection device on various aspects. So this is the battery. This is the typical image of the BMS. It is a 19S 60 volt 40 amps BMS for this LFP battery pack. If you see here, the right side, there is one thick black wire and thick blue wire. The thick black wire is P minus. It will be printed there in the gadget itself. So this is P minus and this is B minus. The P minus, you should connect that P minus with the power output. So that is the power output. You can draw the power only from this black wire P minus. The B minus, you have to connect it with the battery's B minus. Okay, you have to do it this way. And the left hand side, you see there is one black wire and 19 red wires. And I think this black, you know, it's not a wire actually, it's a sensor. This is a temperature sensor. This protects from the high temperatures. So this first black wire should be connected with the B negative. And the very next red wire is called the first red wire. The first red wire is to be connected to the first cell positive. Similarly, the second red wire, it should be connected with second cell positive. In the same way, the 19th red wire should be connected to 19th cell positive. So you have to do this way only. Suppose if you give a wrong connection, the entire battery pack will not work properly, or this may get damaged. The BMS may get damaged. So the battery positive shall be directly connected with the output. So I said two different types of motors, you know, hub motor and drive motor. In this e-scooter, we use the hub motor. And single phase, three phase are brush DC or brushless DC. So this motor for this e-scooter is coming under this category. It's a three phase motor or BLDC motor. Hub motor, of course. So this is the controller that we used for this hub motor or for this vehicle. The three wires and the Hall sensor, you have to connect these three wires and this connector with hub motor. And this the throttle wires to be connected with this connector. And this is a three speed connector for the three speed option. Here if you see, this is the switch, three stage switch available in the throttle, low, medium, high. You can choose low, medium, high speed while you are using the vehicle. And another one is the reverse. You see, there is another switch here, FR. F means forward and reverse. So generally for our two wheeler, even though this switch and this connector is available in this controller, we did not use this forward reverse, because by mistake, if they press while they are using this vehicle, suddenly suppose if they use this switch from forward to reverse, the motor may get damaged. So we did not use this particular connection for our vehicle, but option is there. And the power lock, in some controllers it will have two wires. If you see the switch here, there are two wires, of course. But here, in controller part, it sometimes it will have two wires, or sometimes it will have only one wire. In our case, it had only one wire. So that means this wire to be connected with any one of these two wires, the other wire to be connected to plus 60 volt. That is a connection. And the battery capacity indicator is must for all the electric vehicles, because you will see two things. One is the voltage, of course, this shows 48 volt. In our case, this case, it's a 60 volt type. So you will see the 60 volt indication and the charge capacity. So after the battery is fully charged, you will see 100%. Then after prolonged usage of your electric vehicle, the charge will go down from 100 to 90, 80, and so on. You have to keep a watch on this, because once it reaches 15% or less, time has come for you, for the vehicle, to charge it. So for that purpose, for all the electric vehicles, you must definitely fix this kind of battery capacity indicator. Let's say about the mission of our project. We planned, as I said earlier, we plan to develop one electric bicycle, one e-scooter, this 1000 watts e-scooter for carrying two persons. So in this video, you are going to see this one. The fourth one, 1000 watts electric two-wheeler for the vendors with a payload capacity of 200 kg. The fifth one, electric car with a seating capacity of 4 persons. Let us see about this one here. We have these expertise. We are capable of making a battery pack for all vehicles with any type of cell, any shape, any size, any voltage, any power output. As of now, we made a battery pack with a capacity of up to 5 kW. But we have the capability in making the battery pack with a capacity of up to even 100 kW. Our facility has excellent spot building facility. We have a complete electronic setup for motor controller assembly and complete testing of electric vehicle controllers and converters. We have the capability of converting any vehicle, be it a two-wheeler, three-wheeler or a four-wheeler, into electric vehicle or making a new EV altogether. Now let's see about how we made this e-scooter carrying two persons. This is the key specs. Rated voltage 60 volt, hub motor power is 1000 watts. The maximum speed you can go up to 55 kilometers per hour. The range 90 kilometers per charge. So if you charge once, you can go up to 90 kilometers. So three drive mode option is available: low, medium, high. So you have seen all these things already. Let me skip it. So this is the battery pack. So we purchased a Mahindra Duro scooter. We removed the engine, we removed the wheel. You see now fabrication work is going on. We removed the current the engine and the rear wheel is a single assembly, no? So while removing the engine, the rear wheel also came out along with the engine. So we fixed this hub motor now at the rear. Okay. So here, the while fabricating, you have to be very careful about the alignment of the front and rear wheels. All these, the front wheel and rear wheel must be coplanar in nature or collinear in nature. At the same time, this is having a four bar mechanism linkages actually. Many people may think that it's a triangular type of setup is enough, but it is not so. Four bar link mechanism like structure is required. Here we have to fix the shock absorber also. We fixed twin shock absorbers, one on the left hand side, other on the right hand side. So fabrication is going on. Now you see the leaf spring shock absorber, this side, one this side, the other one on the other side. And you see here, so this is the hub motor. The battery, we kept it in the this compartment, and we kept all the controllers in this place. Now you can see the how the vehicle is running. So this is the battery pack, hub motor, you can see the pickup. The pickup is very decent pickup. That is pickup, or the acceleration is really nice. So we made this e-scooter converting a petrol Mahindra Giro into electric vehicle. So we did this particular project in a matter of just 2 months time. This is myself. Okay, so thank you for watching. If you have any queries or any clarifications required in making an electric vehicle of this kind, you can always post your questions and queries. We are ready to provide you the answers for all your queries. Okay, thank you for watching.